I'm Tori Blankenship with Western Dressage Riding Gear, getting ready to ship you this saddle. Traveling saddle. Once it arrives, it'll be in this box. You want to go ahead and be careful when you open it. Don't just take your knife and dab into it. Slide it along. Go ahead and open up the packing tape. Go ahead and ship it to you in a protective saddle carrier. Go ahead and roll it out of the case. Put it on a saddle rack. Here is the traveling saddle. Go ahead and remove the protective horn cover. Put that back in to your saddle box, and when you're ready to ship it back to us, it'll be there. We'll also go ahead and send along a girth for you to try it out too. I think it's a 28-inch girth, but you're all set. Go ahead and fit this saddle to your horse and take a ride in it and experience the unbelievable technology for yourself. To begin the saddle fitting, grab a towel or a sheet, just something thin that you don't mind getting dirty if your horse is dirty, but you want it thin to go ahead and check the fit of this saddle on your horse. We're going to be using two very different conformational type horses. This horse has very predominant withers, a very strong point of the shoulder blade, the scapula, and then the dip right here, which makes it so hard for saddle fit to be comfortable and true for a horse. So we're going to take our towel, place it over in place of our saddle pad. Put the traveling saddle on. Saddle fitting, what you want to do first is look at the saddle and make sure it looks like it's balanced. It's sitting straight, it's not dipping down, it's not riding high, it's sitting nice and flush and balanced on the horse's back. The second point you want to look at, the most important point, is the wither clearance. So come in front of the saddle, check the clearance between the horse's withers and the saddle. Make sure you can get your hand in there without a problem. There's no pressure at all. That looks like it's good. Then we'll go ahead and girth up the saddle and check for the pressure points. And before we go ahead and tighten up the girth, the saddle placement, and the point of the shoulder. Like I said before, this horse has a very predominant scapula at the tip of the shoulder. You don't want the saddle resting right on that. And when you put the saddle on your horse, I like to gently rock it back and forth. As you're sliding it back, the saddle's going to stop right there once it goes beyond the point of the shoulder right there. And again, our flexible tree here is going to help get out of the way of this horse when he's moving and working. The rigging options on this saddle, you have your dropped rigging built right into the seat of the saddle. The drop rigging takes the pressure of the girth and separates it all the way across the top of the saddle. Instead of traditional rigging, the 7/8 in front concentrates it right around the girth of the horse. This takes the whole pressure of the saddle, disperses the girth across it. The dropped rigging works best for most horses. When you girth it up, avoid the temptation to want to put the girth too far forward. That let the girth lie right underneath the center. The drop rigging. Snug it up like you're going to ride. Check the balance of the saddle again. Now that we've got the girth tightened and we're ready to ride, make sure it's still setting nice and even. Not dipping down, not popping back. Nice level seat. Check the clearance of your withers again. Make sure you've got plenty of room to put your hand in there without obstruction. Make sure that there's no part of the saddle touching your horse's withers. Then you want to check the point of the shoulder. I like to go ahead and move the horse and heel. So take your hand and go ahead and push it up underneath until you can actually cup the point of his shoulder, the top of his shoulder there. So I feel his shoulder in the palm of my hand, and I feel the saddle on the back side. Watch your feet when you need to do this. I'm going to ask him to do a circle around me so I can feel his shoulder blade moving back and forth, back and forth. And I can feel that there is no pain, no pressure. I can feel the saddle moving on top of my hand. You want to do that with both sides. Horses aren't perfect from right to left, just like we're not either. But this saddle kind of makes up for the imperfections. And again, take your hand, push it up, up, up until you can feel the top of his shoulder blade, cup his shoulder blade, and watch your feet and have him walk around you so that I can feel the shoulder blade, back and forth, feel the saddle moving on top of my hand. Nice and comfortable for this horse. Now that we know, you know, confirmed, it's a good fit for him, we're going to go ahead and put the saddle blanket on, re-girth it up, and take him for a ride. Now we know that the saddle's a great fit, let's go ahead and put on a saddle pad. I'll show you the different rigging options if you go for a ride. This is our Myatex 100% wool saddle blanket. Since we know we don't have to correct the fit of the saddle with a specialty saddle pad, this molds to the horse's back just like a sock. It's not going to bunch up and get stiff in certain areas. It's just going to mold to every curve that he has, just like the saddle is going to mold and move with every curve he has too. Here we go again. I always like to tent the front of the saddle pad. Go ahead and just raise it off the withers. Pull out the mane hair that might be stuck underneath there. Just like I showed you before, rock the saddle back to its seat spot. It is going to stop once it gets beyond the point of the shoulders. Take the saddle, you know, rock it back and forth as you're guiding it back. And right there, it locks right in, right off of the shoulder, right behind it. Okay. Which rigging option you choose depends on your horse's conformation and the way he moves. When you first try the saddle out, stick with the traditional drop rigging. And depending where you like your extra girth to go, it does have your high strap hold up here, or you can go ahead and put it through the back as well. If you ride your horse and you find that the saddle is moving a little back on him, this happens with longer backed horses, horses that have, much like him, a very hollow spot on the back side of their shoulder blade. If the saddle travels back on him while you're riding him, then go ahead and try out the center fire rigging. And the center fire rigging, you want to put it the same on each side. So let's go ahead and set it up for that. So if you have a horse with a longer back, or when you ride him with the traditional drop ringing, if the saddle does travel a little bit backwards, then try out the center fire ringing. So you want to set it up the same way on the right side as you do on the left side. Once, then take it through the back rigging to create your center fire ring. Snug it up. You can see how that totally changed where that girth is. Much further back behind the shoulder, incorporating the whole saddle. Behind, in front, or you can double it up and pocket it right in your girth if you prefer that as well. Then the final rigging option just kind of incorporates both of them. You want to remove your tie strap from the front hardware. Get it out of the way. And go ahead and apply your tie strap to the rear rigging. Much like the center fire, but it's going to focus a little bit more on the front. Front hardware. Again. Snug it up. You can see the difference of the girth placing here. A little more forward. A happy medium. It's not your traditional drop rigging and not as far back as the center fire. It just gives you yet another option to fit your horse's conformation the best. So when you do your first ride, ride in the traditional, ride in the center fire. If you're still not happy, go ahead and switch out the tie strap and try this and see what you like and what your horse likes the best. Okay, let's ride. And this is a totally different conformation style. He's a younger horse. You can see he hardly has any withers. He's really flat and straight on his cup line. But we'll just do the same saddle fitting to show you the differences in what to look for in a different style, body style horse. Same thing, take a thin blanket sheet, just a liner. Go ahead and do your fitting. Is not going to be so evident since he doesn't have those very, very high tips of his shoulder blades. Go ahead and rock the saddle back and forth lightly as you pull it back. Go ahead and do a stop. So again, evaluate the saddle. It's sitting nice and level, not dropping down. Run your impatient stop. Check the wither clearance. And again, front of this saddle, you can see he doesn't have withers. There's tons of clearance, but the Sil-cush pads are doing their jobs supporting the saddle on each side of his little baby withers. Okay, great. And we'll go ahead and girth him up. Again, choose the traditional drop down rigging first to try the fit of your horse. Put the saddle on your horse. And check the balance. It's snug, we're ready to ride. The saddle is still nice and balanced, not dropping down the front or the back. You want to check the wither clearance again. Of course, he doesn't have any withers, but you can see where the Sil-cush pads are doing their job supporting that saddle up on the horse's back. You want to check what his withers are feeling underneath, or the tip of his shoulders are feeling. Go ahead and slide your hand underneath. Up those little bitty baby shoulder blades.
I can feel his shoulder blade on the palm of my hand and the saddle on the back side. Go ahead and ask him to round about. And you can feel that scapula moving back and forth, back and forth. I can feel the saddle flexing on top of my hand. You want to do it on both sides. Slide your hand under, up the tip of that shoulder blade. Ask him to circle around. Feel his shoulder working underneath there without any pressure. Some of the center fire ringing on this boy with his lack of maturity, lack of definition, the withers. Oh, that's okay. We'll throw it too. We'll try the center fire ringing. See if that's going to accommodate him. Better in the traditional drop down. And again, he's watching how his back moves with the saddle. Behind the saddle, you can see the clear channel. Behind, you can see the Sil-cush padding, and then the total freedom and no pressure for that spine to go ahead and work and to bend and move. Now it's time to say goodbye to the wonderful traveling saddle and send it back to us. I know you're going to hate to part with it, so get ready to order your own. Anyway, before you wrap it up, we ask that you take a look at it. If there's any area of dirt or mud or debris, just take your favorite saddle cleaner and just go ahead and just briefly wipe it off. Just get rid of any mud or sweat or dirt or debris, nothing major. Just try to help this saddle. It's logged lots of miles. Grab the horn cap that was on it when you received it. Wrap up that horn cap to prevent any damage to the horn. Zip it back up in the saddle carrier that it came in. Up and then roll it into the box on its saddle horn and the pommel and just gently lower it in there. Fold the stirrup over. Fold the stirrup over. And then some heavy duty tape it up and go ahead and address it to be returned back to us. We'll go ahead and send the information how to get it back to us with the traveling saddle or talk to you about that before we ship it out to you.